I've been having a lot of fun today. I want to let you in on a little bit of the fun. After you see the context, you see, wow, spiritual humor starts arising. All the different ways that we try to sell God on nothing. Yeah, then we start, hundreds of ways. I start even just, my gosh, it's funny. And we should have a good laugh at it. That's what else is there to do, is be waiting to, you know, waiting to set the marketing campaign down. We can have a good chuckle at all the different ways we try to sell guys. Say, God, you know what, God, I'm not even interested in selling you anymore. In fact, I don't even want you to buy it. I'm not even selling it anymore. Forget it. I'm taking it off the market. I've taken nothing off the market. Not for sale anymore. Nah. You're not worth it. Not even going to sell it to you. Forget it. I'll just keep it for myself. Teach you a lesson. You don't want to buy? You don't want to buy this? You kidding me? You don't want to buy this? This nothing? This non-existent product? You don't want to buy that? Are you kidding me? You kidding me? Everybody wants this. This is what everybody wants. How can you not want it, God? How can you not want it? It's impossible. You have to want it, right? Well, God, if you're not going to buy it, I'm just going to stop believing in you altogether. I mean, in fact, you're unbelievable. Because you don't want to buy what's so awesome. You want to buy this awesomeness? You kidding? Well, you don't expect us to even believe you're real then. I mean, come on. We're just going to stop believing you're real altogether. How do you like that? I'll punish you a little bit, huh? Show you something that's really amazing. Nobody else knows about it. I don't want anybody else to know about the secret. It's a secret. If anybody else knew about it, they'd get it like that. So, I want to show you something really special. Very special. Only for you. See, there's nothing created with this product. Isn't that amazing? Trying to market nothing to God. I said, God, I'll tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I don't make this deal for everybody either, I'm telling you. It's only because you're God that I'm making you this deal. And I'm gonna cut the price down for you, just for you alone. You know what, God? I was never gonna do this. I gotta be honest with you, God. I was never gonna do this. I was never gonna sell this. It's too precious. But you know what, God? You're so great. You're so awesome. You're such an awesome God. That I'm gonna do something that I said I'd never do. And that is, I'm gonna sell you this nothing. This force change, this death. I'm gonna sell you death. And you know, I hope you buy it right now, because I'm going to change my mind in just a moment or two, because I must be out of my mind. You know what, God? I must be crazy today. I woke up this day, God, and I was just absolutely crazy. You know what came in my mind, God? I said, you know what? I'm going to sell this nothing death to you today. It's nothing. Sell this nothing non-product to you today. And I don't know what possessed me, God. But I'll tell you what. You better get it quick before I sober up. You know what? You know what, God? I've been drinking all night. And I'm just gone. I'm absolutely slammed. And I tell you what, I'm in such a state that I'm even willing to sell you nothing right now. But if I sober up, let me tell you something. You ain't got no chance. You ain't got no chance of buying that from me. They're gonna take it away from me. Are you kidding me? But I'm out of my mind right now. So here you go. Take it. Say yes. Yeah. God, you know, I've been unhappy all my life because I know at some point I'm going to have to sell this to you. And I've suffered a lot knowing this. And I can't suffer anymore. I got to tell you something, I can't suffer anymore. I decided I'm finally going to sell it to you. Finally. I finally decided. This is the moment. My whole life I've suffered trying to hold on to this, and it just hurts me so bad to let go of this now, God. But I just have to let go of it for you, just for you. You know what? You know what the problem is? You know, everyone, you know, God is saying yes to you, but you aren't saying yes to God because you don't want to sell him. God is there and he wants to buy it today from you. He wants to buy it from you right now. This instant, he wants to buy it from you. And you hold him back. That's a sin. That's a sin. You got to repent from that sin. And you got to sell it to God. You got to be willing to give it up to God. You got to be willing to sell him that non-existent product. Because only then are you going to be free. You're never going to be free unless you finally decide to sell it to God. Because God wants to buy it from you today. This is all a marketing campaign. All of existence is a marketing campaign. There's many, many different styles. You know, you got to start laughing at it. You got to start having humor about it, actually. Gotta tell you, I understand your problem. I understand the situation. Yeah, I really do. And what I'm gonna do is, I know it's tough for you to buy this, but I'll tell you what I'm doing. I'm gonna do an installment. Just make a down payment, and we'll start from there. We'll do monthly payments for you, And actually, God, you got an option. You can lease it too. You got a lease option on this. So we've got it all figured out for you. Got the paperwork here for you to sign, and lease with an option to buy. We'll accept your word as down payment on this, your good faith. You know you got good credit, right? Right? Okay. Yeah, we ran a credit report on you. You got A1 credit, so we're gonna take your word on a down payment, and start out with a lease to buy. How about that? Can't beat it. We'll give you time to think about it. God, I got a present to give to you. I've wrapped it up in this nice package, a beautiful bow, and here's a card expressing my sentiments. So would you please accept this gift of my love to you? Here's a gift. Just accept it, please. We can't even give it away, you know. God, I'll tell you what, we're moving it out, we're blowing it out. In fact, we're giving it away today. We're giving it away. I just must be crazy, but I'm giving it away today. So, we got this nothing here to give to you. We got this non-product to give to you. And all we need for you is to sign on the dotted line that you receive this gift. And that's it. We're done. God, I composed a song about you and buying this for me. I want to sing you that song now. And the only thing missing from that song, God, is for you to actually accept. So I want to sing you that song. And I want you to know that's coming from my heart. And I want you to know it's so important to me. I want you to know you're very special to me, God. And I hope, God, after hearing this song, you'll find it in your heart. Take this product from me, please. I know you'll cherish it. It's a sign of our covenant. It's a sign. It's an everlasting sign of our covenant. All you gotta do is take this death from me, non-existent product from me, this forced changeness from me. Just buy it from me, God. Accept it from me. And I'll be your eternally grateful, actually. Eternally grateful for this. We're wheeling and a dealing today. I tell you what, guys, we're wheeling and a dealing. Come on down. Got some for you. As a matter of fact, we're going to run a, why don't you, you're a contestant on our show? Come on down. We're going to show you what you won today. You won this death today. Isn't that great, guys? Take it home with you and have a good time. Secret research, very, very amazing research with this really crack research team, and really pulled in some of the top minds in the world. We've been working on this for a long time, and we've finally come up with the finished product. It's just taken an enormous, you know, global effort, actually. In fact, it's been a cosmic effort. We pulled in people from all over the cosmos to work on this one, man. And it's been top secret, but we want to just, we want you to be the first to know. We want you to be the first to know that we have completed the product for you. And we'd like to present it to you. And we'd like to give this product to you, God. And in fact, we have a lot of notables and dignitaries here today. This very nice ceremony. I hope you'll appreciate the ceremony. It represents a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication, a lot of hours, a lot of brain power, a lot of cooperation, a lot of harmony, a lot of great ideas. And so we really hope that you appreciate this this ceremony and this ritual. And we know we do expect that you will be quite receptive after watching this and understanding everything we've been through and our dedication to succeeding with this. So, and we're just looking for a little yes at the end of all of this, that's all. There's not much there, just a little yes. We got an announcement to make. We have succeeded in a brand new innovation. In fact, we have succeeded in fundamentally making a quantum change, and transcended our previous product, God. And we have now, we're delighted, you know, that we had the capacity, even you must have given us the capacity, we praise you for the capacity to finally put this in the appropriate form for you, appropriate form of nothing for you, non-product, the form of a non-product. We now have finally innovated, enough innovation that, here it is, here it is, come and get it, here it is, come and get it, God, come and get it, God, we got it here for you, just waiting on you. Just waiting on y'all. Yeah, come on, get it. We're all hanging around with it here. We got it here waiting for you. We'll keep it warm. We'll keep the light on for you. We all know it's here. That's why we're here. That's why we're waiting. Just waiting on y'all. You know, God, I'm just like blown away. I'm just like, I can't even express, you know, how awesome it is that I actually have this to offer to you. You know, it's just amazing. It's just like, to me, it's just like means everything that I'm able to finally to offer this to you, this offer up to you. Death, yeah. and your acceptance will truly save me and truly render all my life and existence meaningful forever. I tell you what, God, what we have here for you is eternal and never change. You'll never change on you. You'll always have it. Don't worry about it. you know, slipping away. It's eternal death for you. It's something that will never change, honey. You always have it. It's a keepsake, token of our unlimited gratitude for everything you've done for us. An expression, a symbol, the utmost utmost gratitude. I guess so. Yeah. What are we gonna try next?
Yeah.
I think I've heard that one before, God. I think I've heard that one before.
Yeah.
That sounds familiar. Yeah, that's a take on the old. So, God, you know what? I've got something new. I've got something new, and I'm gonna trade this one in. Do you? Actually, I'm going to trade this death in, do you? Because I got something new that's a lot better, you know? So, you know, I got nothing else to do with this. I might as well take it, you know? Might as well take it. I'm going to throw it away anyway, you know? Just might as well take it. I hate to throw it away. It's kind of a, you know, got some sentimental value to me. So, God, if you could just keep it for me, that'd be great. God, I don't want to sell anything to you. I don't want to sell anything to you at all. As a matter of fact, I don't need to sell you anything or give you anything. But you know, if you want it, I don't care. I don't care if you, you know, it doesn't mean anything to me. It doesn't bother me at all, one way or the other. If you want it, you want it. It's fine. Whatever. Whatever. It's nothing to me. You're welcome to it if you want it. No big deal. No big deal. Care less. I care less if you take it or not. Doesn't make any difference to me. I care less. Uh-oh. God, looks like you finally found me out. Oh, shoot. I was hoping that you wouldn't find me out, but yeah, I admit I've got this. I've been hiding this from you. All this time I've been hiding it from you, and I was trying to hide it from you forever, actually, because it's so valuable. But now that you caught me red-handed, yeah, I got to give it up to you. Not, what else can I do? You know, here you go. Here you go. I'm sorry. I'm hiding something so valuable from you. It's terrible on my part. Just terrible. I'm really sorry about that. Here you go. Here's nothing. Here's the most wonderful non-existent product for you. I'll turn it over. I've been caught. You know, God, I gotta admit something to you. A long time ago, I stole something from you. I feel real bad. My conscience has been bothering me for a long time. And, I'm here to make amends. I'm here to make amends, and I'm here to return what I stole from you. And I'm this is the best I can do, and I'm just real sorry. And so, if you could just accept this back from me. I know it'd take the burden of sorrow and guilt, my conscience, everything. I'm built asleep. Ever since I stole this from you, I've been feeling terrible, you know. And so I'm just real grateful that you take it back from me and I want to return to the rightful owner, you know. And God says, I heard that one too, you know. I heard that one too. Okay, it's a good one, but I heard that one too. God, I brought you here today to unveil the holiest of holies. And so, without further ado, we'll turn it over to you, and all you gotta do is lift this covering off of the off of the cornerstone here, and this will sanctify and bless, and will be complete. It'll be complete. All you gotta do is do that to make it complete. It's just missing that one thing. You just take that. Take that for yourself. And yeah. We wanna give you an honorary prize. Wait, God. Did you get the letter, God? I sent you a letter. Did you get the notification? You haven't called me. He says, well, you got the notification. Or you've won the big prize. You know, you got 10 days to respond. You know, you got to claim your prize, or else you're going to lose it. You got the big, you won the big prize, actually. Is it the biggest one ever, the biggest sweepstakes we've ever had. And this is just great. I'm really happy to be able to tell you that you won. You won this wonderful non-existent product that we have called death. And this is something that I know you'll always, it's going to change, transform your life for sure. We understand that. Hasn't heard so much, but I don't know, it's pretty difficult, right? It's probably heard them all. So we're thinking. God, we just came up with this new product, and we're interested in getting some feedback on this, some reviews on this. So if you would just sort of test drive this product for us, we'd really appreciate, you know, your feedback. We really and respect and admire and know that, you know, if anyone could give us the right feedback on this, it's a new design, something that, you know, maybe not be, everything may not be perfect the way you want it, but if you could let us know, you know, what kind of things do we need to maybe change or alter, you know, and so we'd really be grateful if you could give us some feedback on that. Give us your opinion of it. God, I got this brand new style. We just came off the new models. Brand new models. Redo. And you gotta look at this one. I mean, we actually designed this one with you in mind. Very much so. And so we'd like to actually offer you this. Free. It's a commemorative model. Special commemorative model. Specifically designed with you in mind, and we'd be really happy if you'd honor us with driving this home. God, you know I don't have much. In fact, I have hardly anything. And you know, those rich people, they can offer you a whole lot, but me, I ain't got anything to offer you. But just this is all I got, God. This is all I got to offer you. And, you know, it means a lot more to me than it does those other people. They can afford it, but me, this is all I got. But you know what I'm going to offer it to you? That's how much I think about you. I'm going to offer you this non-existent product. That's okay. You can take it. Don't feel sorry for me. Don't feel sorry for me. I know I ain't got nothing else, but you know, it, you deserve it. You deserve it. Don't worry about me. Nah, it's okay. It's okay. I'll get over it. I'll get over it. You know, God, someone told me today that I was told I understand it. I've got to give this up to you now, finally. You know, it hurts my heart a whole lot to do this, but I know in order to be right with you, I need to give it back to you and give it up to you. And it breaks my heart. It really breaks my heart. But, you know, I have to find some way to get over it. So. Really tough to part with something so precious like this. So I cherish so much precious. You know, it's my everything, actually, guys, my everything. But I understand that I've got to give it to you. So here you go. It's awful, just terrible. Parting with loved ones, parting with something so beloved. I can't tell you how my heart breaks, but take it. Don't prolong the anguish, God. Take it now. Don't make me wait. Breaking my heart. Don't make me suffer any longer. I just don't want to see it anymore. I just don't want to see it around anymore. Here you go. Just take it from me. Take this non-existent death from me. Take this non-existent product from me, God. Then, yeah. I just don't want to think about it. Yeah. Hey God, hey, how you doing? I'm feeling great. Gosh, you know, I'm feeling so good today. I feel like sharing. I feel like just it's one of those days. It's a hallelujah day for me. It's a hallelujah day. And, you know, giving you this non-existent product is just a topper for the day, man. It's just how I feel today. I don't know how I feel. So, hallelujah, here you go. Yeah. Yeah, it's great. It's all good. I'm just in that way. That's the way I am. That's just the way I am. Especially today. It's just the way I am. You can have it all, as a matter of fact. It's just the way I am. It's just, you know, chalk it up to, you know, just the grace is just flowing. You know, the grace is flowing, God, I want to tell you. Grace is flowing so much right now. I can just feel the grace flowing right now. I feel like it's lifting a burden off of me, God. I just feel like the grace is moving, and my God, the grace is going, and the burden is going, and you're accepting. I see you accepting the burden from me. Oh, thank you, Lord. You're accepting the burden from me. The grace is going. Oh, wow. It's awesome. Yeah, you're accepting it. I can see you accepting it from me. Thank you, God. This is mighty, mighty. You're mighty, God. Tell you what, God, I'm going to sweeten the deal a little bit. See, this is the way I am. I understand that times are tough. Maybe, you know, it's one of those situations where, you know, you're holding out for a little more. I understand that. I'm going to sweeten the deal a little bit. Just tell me what you want. Just tell me what you want. And we'll close this deal right now. Guess what, God? Cosmic configuration suddenly all clicked and aligned. And guess what that means, God? It means I get to give you this non-existent product now, because the whole cosmos, I've been waiting for this for a couple billion, maybe billion years, actually. And this is the moment. All cosmic centers aligned perfectly. And this causes opening of opportunity of acceptance with divinity. And so now I realize this is the moment for me to give you this. This is the moment of transference. Let it be so. Amen. This is awesome, man. Here it is. No holding back. It's impossible to hold it back at this point. It's just all a cosmic alignment thing. You know? God, you know what? I've been transformed. We just went through the photon belt, and this is like key to all my genetics, and I've got all my strands back, all the chakras are firing, and now I can see clearly. You know, before I couldn't see clearly. Now I see totally clearly. My God, I didn't know I could give you this before, God. But thanks to your unbelievable grace and how this has all worked, and now my eyes are open, I can see. My holy cow, you know, how incredible. I was so stupid before. I was blind. I was like I was asleep or dreaming. But now I'm awake and I can see this. I can give you this. Isn't that awesome? Here you go. Here it is. Here it is. Yeah. We're trying hard. We're trying real hard, aren't we? You know, God, I've got this. You know, I've got it actually, and that's the problem because all these others, you know, are trying to get it from me. They want to attack and make war on me. You know what, it's just too much for me. If you could just keep it for me, you know, just keep it for me, just take it from me. And so they just get all these pressure off of me because everybody wants it, you know, I understand that. Everybody wants to be able to give it to you, but I have one who actually has it. So if you could just take it from me, you know, protect me from all this stuff, I'm finished without washing my hands with it, you know. It's too hot to handle, too hot to handle. Well, you know, God, I'm finally ready. I'm finally ready. I just wasn't quite ready before. I've seen the light. So now I'm ready. You can have it. You can have it now. I'm trying to come up with something different. Hey, God, you know what? I'm sorry I've been trying to sell this to you all this time, try to give this away, give this non-existent product to you all the time. And I understand that a lot of the ways we try to do this, it just hasn't been the right. We're very sorry about that. Very sorry about insulting you, that somehow you would accept it in those, you know, just blatant attempts to, you know, sell this to you. It's really, I'm very ashamed, you know, we're all ashamed that we tried all these different ways to trick you into buying this, but we just feel terrible about this. Just be terrible, feel terrible about it. So, you know, if you could just forgive us and accept it from us just out of forgiveness, you know, then we could just be done with this, you know, be done with it forever, actually. Or we're not going to even try any more ways for you to take this from us. We're not going to even try anymore. We're finished. We're finished. But just out of, you know, just for no reason at all, God, actually. You don't need to take it for any reason at all. Just because you love us, you know, you just forgive us and understand that we're not trying to give it to you or anything like that, but if you could just, out of your grace, just take it from us, and we'll never talk about it again, and it's done, and, you know, we'll forget about the past, actually, forget about it all. That's a good one, that's a good one. I heard that before, though. The anointing, and I realize that I am the one that was prophesied, that I am the one who will finally be able to give you this gift, this awesome gift. And we finally realize, I know that nobody else can give it to you. That's why you haven't accepted it yet, because it was prophesied that there would be one who would come, and that would be the one that you would accept it from, and I am that one, God. So, here it is. Here it is. I have the anointing to give this to you. I have the commission. I am the one that you receive it from, God. Just a minute. God, I'm about ready to die, but before I die, I just want to give you this one gift. My last breath, I want to give you this gift. That's how much it means to me. Yeah, you take it for me. Oh, keep it for me. It's important for me. Yeah. feels so terrible. It's just, you know, if you, I don't know why, but you know, maybe I don't know what to try. But if you could just take this, or let's at least try it. You know, let's give it a try. I've tried everything to heal this. I haven't been able to heal it, but let's just give this a try. Yeah, take it. Just give it a try. Nothing wrong with trying. Doesn't hurt to try. God, we just randomly assign all these prizes to everybody. Just everyone's got these random prizes, and this just happens to be your random prize. So here you go. And thank you very much. We cooked this specially for you, God. We made it especially for you. Hope you enjoy it. Hope you enjoy it. I want you to know, God, that we have said over 10 million prayers from 10 million people, all focused on this, and we have energized it, and we have blessed it, and we have infused it with the awesomeness that we know you deserve. And so now, without any further ado, we know that it has been properly sanctified, and here it is. Here it is. Here's the non-existent product of forced change, death. So you can enjoy it forevermore. And it's sanctified. It, actually, God, we have sanctified it for you. Yes, we have. Through appropriate rituals that you gave us, and appropriate prayers and everything, it has now been entirely sanctified. All corruption has been removed from it. It's been purified. And now, take it. Yeah, God, I found this. I just wander around. I found this. I just wonder, what do you think of it? I don't really know what to make of it. You know, it was very unusual. Yeah, I'm just sort of puzzled. You got many opinions out there. You can help me out with this and this. What is this, anyway? What is this non-existent product? I don't quite understand it. You know, God, I just need a little help. I just need a little help. I don't quite understand. It just feels like our relationship, it just is, something is just missing from our relationship. Just a little bit. I just need a little help here. So if you could help me understand you better. If you could help me understand you better, I know that would be a big help to me. God, I'm just returning this to you. I think you lost it. It came down from heaven, you know, just one day. And you know, I said, gosh, I bet you this came from God. In fact, I'm sure it did. So I'm just returning it to you. I hope you haven't, you know, I know you've been missing it. You know, I hope you haven't missed it too much. It's just, it's awful to lose something like this, you know, something so precious like that. To lose it like that is terrible. So here you go. Sorry about that. I mean, it just fell down from heaven one day. I'm just happy I found it for you. Just happy I could be of help. Happy I could be of service in that way. God, I don't know if I'm ready for this, but we've worked a long time, and I'm going to take the risk. I'm going to take a big risk right now. I'm going to take a big leap of faith right now, and I'm going to make that leap of faith that, you know, I'm ready to surrender this to you. This is my leap of faith, and I just hope you accept this gift from me, and grace my life forevermore by your acceptance of this. So I'm just making that leap of faith is all. That's all I'm doing. Maybe God is bored. He said, I've heard all these before. You know, come on. Man, see, I've heard all these before many times. Many, many times. God, I just want to finally tell you that it finally worked. What you told us to do finally worked, you know. We got the mantoids and the reptoids and everybody, the Pleiadians and the Greys and the whole gang working on this for, you know, now. And we reversed engineered, bioengineered, we ritualized, I mean, we've done everything we needed to do, everything you told us to do. And so it looks like it's finished. We finally finished it. We finally finished it for you. It's been a big project, I want to tell you, but it's finally done. Here you go. Here you go. Here it is for you. You know what your problem is, God? You gotta lighten up a little bit, you know? You just gotta loosen up, lighten up, just realize that your opportunity is better, you know? Just, this big opportunity, just too serious, you know? You just lighten up a little bit. You know, you'll see, you'll be able to see what I got for you. You're not seeing it. You're too mental. You know, you just get into your heart, God. You just get into your heart and feel with your heart. You'll be able to see it with your heart, what I have for you. It's a heart gift. It's coming from my heart, actually. Yeah, it's a heart gift, one heart to another. And you'll see it. You know, you can see it if you do. You're too something. This is just, you know, there's just some hang up there. You just, I'm going to help you with that. If you can get past that hang up, everything will be great. And be able to accept it, you know. This is the age, God. We finally have entered the age now where we see what our potentiality and capabilities really are. And we now realize we are capable of giving this to you. We really are. We are capable of completing this awesome product we have for you. And finally, you know, being able to market it to you and get it in an acceptable format. So we're like really excited, very excited about this. And looking forward to the day that will come soon, we know, where you will finally accept this from us. So everybody feels great here, God. Everybody feels great. I mean, you know, look at the world. We're all super happy because we all know that day is coming soon. That day is really coming soon. And that's why we're all happy here. We all know it's coming real soon. Real soon. So rejoice, rejoice. You know, spread the word, hallelujah, rejoice. So. You know, yes we can, yes we can. You know, we know we can, yes we can. Look at us, we're just getting this lift off, you know, feeling potential here. We're just gonna lift it off for you. We're just going to levitate it right into your ever-loving arms, and wow, this is it. Got the whole band here, everything's here. Yeah, big deal, really big deal. God, I got something to tell you. It's amazing what's just happened. We just located this shaman in the rainforest. Huh. It's been there, you know, nobody even knew that these people existed. And you know, there's like these berries there that they have. It only grows there. And these berries, you know, have this amazing health benefits. In fact, the people there are like totally pure and uncorrupted, you know. And this shaman actually has, well, I'll tell you, this is amazing, I know, but has told us that the shaman is willing to perform, actually be the one that performs the transference ceremony, that he's actually able to do this for us. It is incredible. You know, it's just amazing what's happened. So, you know, isn't it wonderful? Isn't life great? If stuff like this can happen, it's just, he must have set it up for us like this. This is fantastic. I said, God, you know, I've been trying to do this on my own, to give it to you on my own, but I finally realized I can't do it on my own. And I finally turned to the goddess. And, you know, it was just my stubborn pride. I said, I want to do it on my own, but now I realize that it's the goddess who does it for me. And so, you know, I finally come to that realization that I can't, I'm not the one who can do it. It's the goddess that can do it. So I just want you to know that I did my best, and it was just my foolish pride that kept me from turning it over to the one who you appointed as the one who will do it for you. You know, I'm really just, what can I say? I didn't quite, you know, didn't understand before. So here's the goddess, and she'll do the appropriate transference of the non-existent product to you. It's a done deal. This is what God has to listen to all the time. This is what God is hearing from us all the time, actually. The new ones, top 10. What are the top 10 ways we try to sell God the non-existent product? God, we have something for you. Except, you know what? It's so bright. We have our little child here, and the child is going to give it to you. And is, you know, you don't want to break the child's heart, do you? You know, we can give it to you, God, but I think you love children so much, and we just want to have a child give it to you. Okay. God, this product, this non-existent product, is a symbol, is a token of all the light and all the love and all the peace and all the harmony and everything that you are. You know, this is just our way of saying thank you for being what you are. This is our expression of gratitude and thanks. So here you go. Struggle I've had to give this to you is causing me, you know, I'm starting to break down, starting to get sick. It's been really a terrible struggle for me. Having to take a lot of meds. You know, I don't feel very good at all. I just wondering, you know, just out of goodness, kindness of your heart, you know, just not for me, not for anybody really, just, you know, why not, it's, I don't mean anything to you, I know one way or the other, but, so, you know, why not, it doesn't matter to you, God, yeah, I can tell, it really doesn't matter to you one way or the other, I understand that, so, why not do it, yeah, it won't hurt anything, it's, flip a coin, you know, this one, you know, whatever, one way or the other, but God, we can tell you really don't want this, but I'll tell you what, you know, we're going to hold our breath until you take it from, because, you know, we don't really don't want it either, so, we're going to just stop breathing. We're not going to do anything. We're going to go on strike. You know, nothing's going to happen here at all, God, until you finally take this, because we don't want it. I tell you what, God, we, if you don't take this, we're never gonna listen to you ever again. We're never gonna do anything you want us to do. Forget it. Forget it. We're finished. We're through. We are through. Ha! You don't want this, then we're through. Through forever. I'll throw this away in the fire. I'll break it in a million pieces. I'll spit on it. I'll step, I'll stomp on it. It's nothing to me anymore. Absolutely nothing to me. I don't want anything to remind me of you ever again. I'm finished. I'm through. I don't want this non-existent product anymore. I don't want that around anymore. You want, take it. You want it? Take it all. I don't care. Take it all. Ruin me. What do I care? I'm tired of holding on, just trying to keep your grubby hands off. I'm tired of this. Yeah, I'll be nothing without it, but you want to ruin me, go ahead, go right ahead. That's what you want anyway. Obviously, you've just been holding out for everything. Well, this is all I got. You know, you're greedy, you want more, 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 more. Well, this is all I got. You might as well take it right now. Ruin me, go ahead. God, we just have an announcement to make that we have actually discovered in the code in your sacred book. We have come across finally the code that you buried there. The secret word we need to say. And this is incredible. So we're ready to say it. We're finally, now we know. Okay. And we thank you for burying it in code in this book, you know, for us. It was a great hiding place. And now we finally discovered by going this way. There it was. This is the word. We understand. Now we understand. So here's the word. We say the word, and here it is. And this is this automatically affects the transfer to you. It's an automatic done deal. It's written. It is written, so let it be done. God, we are in the process of sacrificing, constant sacrifice, one after the other, one after the other, one after the other, because you told us that this is what we need to do in order for to allow this transference to take place. So we just want you to know that we engage in this great, great, and holy sacrifice here, and that we're almost done with it, actually. And we just want to give you a heads up that we'll be finishing, you know, fairly soon. And at that time, the transference will be taking place. So, just giving you a heads up on that. Okay. God's saying, oh, wow, okay. Yeah, I've heard that one too. And done that. Yeah, he tried that one many times too. Thank you, God. Thank you so much. Thank you. God, for what? I just want to thank you. I just want to thank you. I want to thank you so much. This is just great. Just great. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for all this. Thank you for taking that off of my hands. I'm so appreciative of what you did for me. I can't tell you how appreciative I am. In fact, it's completely transformed me, and it's really saved the whole universe. Actually, it's just, that's how. So I want to thank you for doing that for me. I want to thank you for doing that for me. Okay. I didn't know. I thought you'd never do it. It's me. I thought you'd never do it. Wow, this is great. What a great day this is. I feel like shouting your praises. I gotta admit, I thought maybe I might not never do it, but you finally did it. That's great. Look at all this world. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that absolutely beautiful? It's incredible. So I'll tell you what. this is even more beautiful. This is an expression of the whole beauty of the whole world. I want to give this to you as a gift, you know, out of love for everything you've done for us. And look how beautiful this is. Just, isn't that incredible? Isn't it exquisite? What a design, huh? Had our best designers working on it. This is what you need, actually. This is what you need. I'm telling you, is what you need. I mean, you cannot do without this. This is it. This is it. You know, and I know it. I know we've both been around and around and around on this a few times, but come on. We know what we're really talking about here. This is what you really need, and you can afford it, too. We know you can afford it. Just between the two of us, come on. Don't give me this, you know, I can't afford it thing and try to lower my price down. Come on, we both know what the game is here. You know, you're trying to get me down. I'm trying to get my price. I got to make a living here. And so, you know, let's get to the deal here. I mean, you're here to buy. I'm here to sell. And that's what we do here. So let's cut to the chase. And let's do a deal. Let's do it right now. God, I got to admit that those you sent to me have worked their magic on me and have brought me finally to my knees where I realized that I must surrender this to you. What can I do? I've been overwhelmed by all the emissaries you sent to me. They've worked their magic on me, and it's done deal. I didn't know you wanted it that bad, to tell you the truth. If I knew you wanted it that bad, I would have given it to you a long time ago, actually. And, you know, it really, you could have just said that, you know, a long time ago that they really wanted it bad. You didn't have to put me through all this stuff and send all your agents there to work on me and convince me, you know, and do all their spells and all this stuff on me, you know. Just let me know that's how bad you wanted it. I would have given it up to you a long time ago, actually. So, here it is, and you don't have to sweat it any longer. You know, you don't have to sweat any longer. You don't have to pester me anymore. You don't have to send out all these agents. You don't have to put me in these terrible situations and torture me and stuff. You know, you're through with all that. You know, it should be your happy day now. God, you took away my this, and you took away this from me, and took away that, and you knocked me down here, and you knocked me down there, and you know what, I just can't take it anymore. You want it that bad, you take it. I just can't take it anymore, actually. Just can't take it anymore. Meditation for it seems like eternity, and I swung into the light, and the light enlightened me. I had a full realization now, full realization is that I now realize that this belongs to you and not to me. It wasn't easy coming to this realization. It's been a long path to finally realize this. Yeah, now I see it belongs to you, not to me. Okay. God, with your grace, your protection, and your inspiration, and your love for me, God, I can tell you something now, that we have defeated the forces of darkness, and we have rescued this precious, precious love, the one you love the most of all. We finally freed it from the bondage that it's been in for so long. And we're just grateful now that you finally have what is most important to you. And we're just grateful we could play a part in that. And there's more and more and more and more and more and more and more. It never stops, does it? It never stops. Variation upon variation upon variation. And God's heard it all. God's heard it all. This guru gave this to me to give to you. So I'm just a messenger. You know, that's all. I'm just a humble messenger. It must be important, I don't know. You know, I can just assume it must be really important. The guru seemed to indicate it was really important, and it's very important that God, that you give this to God, and don't, you can't fail. As a matter of fact, God, take this, please. I'm actually a slave, and I work for this terrible slave owner. It's just horrible. Beats me all the time. And the slave owner said that it's my job to give this to you. And if I don't give it to you, he's gonna beat me to death. So I'm gonna be beaten to death, actually, God. So here, take it. That's my lot in life. At least you can spare me from that, God. At least you can spare me from being beaten to death. Being a slave is bad enough. Hi, God. What are you looking for? Why are you here? You shouldn't be looking in here. This is my place. Hold on. Just a minute. Not quite. Okay, God, why are you here? What are you looking for? You're here for something? What is it? Tell me, what is it? Oh, you're not sure? Oh, I think I might know what you're here for. I think I might know. I got some ideas, at least, right? I think I might know what you're looking for. I'll tell you what. Look for it really nice. I might give it to you. Yeah. That'd be very nice, though. Maybe not today. Maybe tomorrow. Come back tomorrow. Maybe we'll talk tomorrow. Okay, God. Yeah. Hey, God's looking for what I have. This is great. Yeah. Not quite ready yet, God. God, you know, I might be able to make an arrangement here. I kind of broker this deal here. I've got this party over here and this party over here, and I'm working on getting an agreement with them or this other party over here. And it looks like we're getting close to brokering this deal here. It's very tough, very touchy. There's a lot of sensibilities involved here. You know how that is. And, We're trying to get the peace here, you know. We're trying to get the peace, and it's been a struggle. But we think we're sort of brokering this peace thing, and then we'll get the peace we need to give this to you, you know. And so if you can just hold on a little bit longer, we'll get this broker for you. I don't know what is that? There's some. Something. Maybe an ant. Interesting. Some insect. Something. The invisible. I tell you what, God. Here it is. We know you can't see it. Because it's invisible. That's why you can't see it. But it's still bona fide, I'm telling you. It's just invisible. We know there's nothing there, you know, but it's the thought that counts, right? It's just the thought that counts, come on. It's just invisible. That shouldn't be a problem, right? And we know it doesn't exist, but it's the thought that counts. Come on. We'll wrap it up for you real nice. This near-death experience, and I saw you, and you told me what you wanted, and so here it is, my gosh, is that near-death experience that did it for me. It's amazing, it came out of nowhere. I never even thought about giving this to you, to tell you the truth. In fact, I thought I was never going to give it to you. In fact, you didn't deserve it. I never even considered this, and then had this near-death experience, and now I realize this is what you really want from me. It's awesome. Know how to teach this or learn it or anything. It just happened. Amazing. Here you go. God, I'm drawing all these devotees unto me, and once they properly come to me and recognize my authority to give you this gift, once that is being completely completed and consecrated, then it shall be done. It shall be done. God, I just dug up this holy book. I was just out in my backyard, and I hit this chest. I opened it up, and there's a holy book of gold in there, and written on it are your instructions about how to give this to you. You must have maybe hit him. Buried him here, actually. Actually, what I realized, what I was told, is that long ago you sent this great guru into the world. And the great guru realized that we weren't quite ready for the instructions. We still wanted to hold on to this great gift we have for you. And the great guru realized that the way to what he has to do is to bury this, and in some future time, there would be one who was already authorized to discover this. And I was just digging, and I discovered this chest. I opened it up, and there's all these gold leaves in here, and these books, and it explains exactly how to give it to you. This is amazing. So without further ado, here it is. Blah, 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 blah. Don't. See? It's completed. So now it's completed. Four of the five buried instructions that we need to complete the transfers of a non-existent product of death to you. But we haven't yet found the fifth one. This is our problem. And so we're just asking you, maybe if you could send the one who can find the fifth one for us, that this would complete. The constructions will be complete at that point. So we're just waiting for that fifth treasure. Where is that? Can you maybe give us a clue about where it is? That would be great. treasures, the ancillary ones, they're also necessary. Okay, where are they also? We need to go look for those. As soon as we find those, we'll know what to do. Thank you for sending us a Savior God and telling us what to do and how to do it. But, you know, we don't quite understand yet. For some reason, we're just kind of dumb. And we haven't quite been able to understand what to do. But if you could just kind of make up the difference for us, that'd be great. But send us another Savior. You know, we're struggling. We're just poor people here. We don't quite understand, you know, these divine mysteries. We understand it's a big mystery, for sure. Really big mystery. It's the mystery of mysteries. You know, we're having a lot of faith. I know it takes a lot of faith here to get, you know, to just understand that you really do want it and for us to part with it. And the whole thing's just a big mystery. And you know, sometimes we think like that you don't really want it or that maybe it doesn't exist or there's things, but then we say, oh my God, I had a lapse of faith here. We got to keep faith here that it's going to happen here for sure. You'll make a way. We know you'll make a way. You're just kind of ask him, you know, can you make a way for us, please? God, what is that? God doesn't exist. Are you kidding? If God existed, it would have taken us a long time ago. God would have taken us a long time ago. God doesn't even exist. Why even bother? Why even bother trying, you know? This is it. This is life. This is what we have. This is our reality. What are we talking about? God, that's ridiculous. Now, God obviously isn't real because if God was real, God would have taken this away a long time ago. All the attempts to do it are ridiculous. Obviously, they don't work because there isn't any God. So, God, you don't exist. You see, I just proven that you don't exist because you haven't taken this non-existent product that we have, death. If you existed, if you're real, you would have taken it a long time ago, obviously. So, you don't exist. You're not real. Take that. Take that. Take that. Take that. Ha. Ha. You know, we just all ignore you for long enough. You'll come around. You'll understand what you need to do. You know, you'll change your mind, you know. We're just all going to ignore you. Don't want you anyway. What are you good for? Not good for anything. Are you kidding? It's ridiculous. You're not good for anything. You can't even take this. It's easy to take, right? I mean, it's like nothing, but it's easy to take it. You can't even do that. You can't do that. What can you do? That should be the easiest thing of all. So, yeah, I mean, might as well believe in the Tooth Fairy. Believe in God, believe in the Tooth Fairy, Santa Claus, and the Easter Bunny. What's the difference? None of them can really do anything anyway. Yeah. So, God, I approve you don't exist, because if you did exist, you would have taken this product, bought this product from us, or taken it as a gift. We could even gift it to you. You know, on your good credit. But you didn't. That's because you don't exist. We're working on it, God. We're working on it here. We're working on it. Just need a little more time. Just a little longer. It's a tough one. It's a toughie. Well, it's toughies, you know. So that's why it's taking us so long. We're not giving up. Keep working on it. I'll just tell you what, God, I'm just going to be silent until you take it. That's it. I got nothing more to say. nothing more to say. That's it. You won't hear a word from me ever again until you dig it. Okay, how long's that been? still haven't taken it? Wow. We'll describe it for you. Yeah, here, to God. There's a nice inscription. Put it on in your trophy case. Yeah, well, God, there's a really amazing story to all this. I'll tell you the story about everything we've gone through. You'll really appreciate it after hearing the story. Everything that's gone into, you know, manufacturing this incredible product we have for you. It's really an amazing story. I know you'll love to hear it. And listening to this story will make you appreciate just how valuable it really is. So, we're going to tell you this story. It's a long story, God. It's the story of stories, actually. The song of songs. God, we're having trouble, you know, fully accepting what you're trying to give us. So I don't think we can quite take it. So you gotta, maybe you'll have to keep it. Yeah, we're just not able to quite, you know, we just don't have quite what it takes to accept this amazing gift of no product at all from you. So you're gonna have to keep it. Yeah, keep it. We're not worthy. We're not worthy, God. We're not worthy. We're not worthy. Not worthy of this, God. It's too much for us. It's too much good stuff for us. This amazing product, non-existent product of death, of forced change. It's just like, wow, we're not worthy of that. So, I'm sorry, but you just have to keep it. And maybe you can find someone else to give it to. We're not worthy of it. Get an A for effort. There's something, a lot of effort into this. God, you know, we know that all of us could have done this for you, but here's this one of us who has special needs, special difficulties, etc. Really challenged in so many ways. And we want him, this one to be the one that gives it to you. Yeah, it's any one of us could have done it, God, you know, but to have this one who's so challenged, I'm going to tell you, it's hard. This is just such a heartful story that, you know, that this one could not function, could not do anything. And then one day, like out of the blue, this one said, I want to give this to God. And it, the first time he's ever said anything, it was like, wow, it's amazing. And we just all believe that this one was born just to do this. It doesn't have any other function here. Can't function at all. It's just pitiful. But this one has that one desire in their heart, just a pure desire to give this to you. So, again, instead of any one of us giving it to you, we're giving the honor to this, the least of us, actually. Even the least of us, God, want to give you this gift. Even the least of us. And this is how important it is. That shows you how loyal we are, how much we love you, the least of us. That when everything else is stripped away, at the heart of it all, that desire to give you this gift is still there. Isn't that amazing, God? Isn't that precious? Just aren't words to describe it. Just isn't words. That this least of us is able to give you this gift of non-existent product here. And we're so grateful that I'm finally able to do that for you. Yeah. God, you know, this one is different than the rest. This one is different than the rest. And somehow, we don't understand it, but they're able to give you this gift, you know? It's like a gift that they have, a gift of giving a gift to you. And we don't know how this happened. It's just different than the rest of us. And, so we're really lucky and fortunate, right? It means that we're all going to be free. Yeah. It's amazing how this stuff works out. Here you go. God, you know, we know you work in very mysterious ways. And the most mysterious of all is that finally we're able to give this gift to you. And I'm telling you, it's just been a miracle after miracle after miracle. And so incredibly mysterious. Beyond our fathoming. Your ways are unfathomable to us. But it's just a total miracle that we're able to give this to you now. This is the miracle of miracles, actually. And without you working your mysterious ways, it's not possible, right? We could never have done it without that. It's not possible. We understand that. It's just all your grace and your mysterious ways that you know, it seems like you can't really take it from us, but somehow the miracles made it possible, you know? It's beyond us, God. You're really beyond us. All of this is a divine mystery, actually. Yeah. Even reason can't even see it. In fact, we can't see it at all. In fact, it seems completely impossible to us. And it actually seems like nonsense to us. God, it's like we thought it was all ridiculous whim on our part, but now we see some kind of divine mystery that all along this is what you wanted. It's amazing. Wonder of mystery, wonder of wonders. God, you finally sent us the sign in the sky we've been waiting for. We've been waiting all this time for you to send us our sign. And now that you finally sent us your sign, here it is. Wonderful, huh? How these things work out in the end. It all works out in the end, right, God? We understand that. All good in the end here. This world is falling into apostate world very rapidly. In fact, it's almost completely collapsed. And so, before it completely collapses, God, and this world turns into apostate world, turning their back on you completely and deciding to keep it all for themselves, before that happens, God, I'm going to give this to you. And then I must flee, because the barbarians are at the gates. So, here you go, take it, quickly, I must flee. There they come, they're after me right now. Here, take it. God, I'm happy I could win this great victory for you. The barbarians are here. They tried to capture this most sacred of sacreds, holy of holies, and I was able, through, you know, great effort and great grace, to triumph, drive them off. And in commemoration of this great victory, I'd like to give this to you. Like a big arch commemorating the whole thing. This is a covenant. Absolutely. Never again will we ever need to give anything to you, God. Now we can live in peace and happiness and in the golden age, because we've finally been able to give you the gift that you so deserved. Hi, God. I'm putting the spell on you, God. I'm the dream weaver, spellcaster, God. Put this dream There you go. Okay, now you're ready to accept this from me, aren't you, God? Because I say, yes, you can. Take it. Yes, you can. I want to take it, right? That's what you think. I want to take it now. We just had to find the right spell to cast on you, God. It's been a tough one. But actually, we were just fooling around. We knew how to do it all along. Piece of cake. We didn't know what you wanted, guys. You know, we're stupid, I guess. We didn't even know what you were after all this time, really. I mean, we're just stupid humans. Well, how could we know? We didn't know. Nobody knew. Nobody knew, really. Yeah. Go ahead. That's all right. Take it. God, I am the one you have been waiting for. And what do I have for you? You know what I have for you. God, another opportunity won't come around like this for another couple billion years, and we both know that. And we cannot miss this opportunity. It's too important, it's too precious. We cannot wait another 2 billion years. So, this must happen right away, right now. We can't blow this one, I'm telling you. Both of us will never get over it. We'll never get over this one. Can't let this opportunity slip away. God, we command you to take this gift. It is our command that you must do this. God, just letting you know, just a little reminder, it's the post-Christmas sale. Take 20% off. 20% off across the board, and actually starting today is a one-day sale. Take another 15% off that. Yeah. Hey. And actually, if you use your such and such card, you're gonna get some cash back too. Qualified buyers only. We now have this incredible deal. And just letting you know, God, that you are, you know, the top qualified buyer, actually. And just letting you in on this auction. Giving you an invite to the auction. We're auctioning it off today, actually. Auctioning off this non-existent product today. Don't want to miss out on this one. This is the one that is tough to find, believe me, there's only one of it in the whole world. It's the only one in the whole world. That's how precious, that's how tough it is to find. Are you kidding me? We heard that there were like some others, but they've been lost. You know, as someone says that it sank with, you know, Atlantis or something, and is at the bottom of the ocean covered. You know, someone else said this was thrown into a volcano, and somehow this one survived all these years. It's amazing, absolutely amazing. And it's up for auction today. Yeah. Only one of its kind in the whole world. God, can you just credit us with finding it? You know we're going to find it eventually. It's hidden. We can't find the product somewhere. But, you know, why don't you just, you know, call it good, accept it in principle, and then when we finally find it, you know, it gets found, then, you know, you'll have it. But in the meantime, we don't have to worry about it. Isn't that amazing what your creation can do? How we're able to do this is a testimony to your creation to be able to come up with this non-existent product for you. It's the glory, you know, it's the absolute glory of your creative genius and your creative glory that your creation is able to bestow this upon you. Singing songs. We're faithful servants here, God. Very faithful servants. But not sure what you're waiting for. You know, what we're waiting for, you're waiting for. But we'll wait together until that time comes. Meanwhile, let us praise you. Let us praise you. Let us thank you for what you're going to do. We thank you for what you're going to do for us. We just don't know when. Doesn't matter. We're not in a hurry. Whenever is fine with us, God. No pressure. There's no pressure. Don't worry. We're grateful. Whenever. Doesn't matter. I mean, we've been waiting a long time, that's for sure. And it isn't easy waiting, but whenever you want to do it, it's fine with us. This is actually a monologue about our day and our lives. This is what we're actually saying to God constantly. This is what we're saying. What a deal I have for you today, God. Let me tell you something. In fact, I don't even want to call it a deal. It's a steal, actually. You know. Come on, let's be honest about this, guys. This is a steal, not a deal. But I'll make it seem like a deal for you, you know, just to keep everything on the up and up and all, you know this. But it's really a steal. Yeah, wow. Wow. I shouldn't be doing this, yeah, you know. To tell you the truth, I shouldn't be doing this. But, you know, it's okay. It's okay. Sometimes we make these deals, you know, that are steals. That happens. It happens. And this one, I'm telling you, this is the top of the toppermost. Pop of the poppermost. It is just, you know, this one's just popping. I mean, it's just jumping off the shelf, or, you know, it's just jumping into your arms, as a matter of fact. I can tell, you know, this is gonna have a happy home, that is for sure. My gosh, they're made for each other. It's amazing, isn't it? Look at this. Look at the two of them together. It's awesome. God and the non-existent product of death. Yeah. Wow. What a fit that is. Who would have thunk it, too? You know, who would have thunk this? It's amazing. It is, wow. It just turned out, everything turned out perfect, didn't it? It's so happy we can make the connection for you, God. This is what we're here for, actually. Make those kinds of connections. Bringing happiness and joy to everyone. Okay, that's this is all good. It's all good. God, is there anything I can get you? Maybe, you know, to sweeten the deal. You want some coffee? You want some, you know, what do you need? Some sacrifices? You know, a bunch of deaths and wars, a bunch of births, a bunch of sickness, a bunch of healthiness, a bunch of, you know, whatever. What do I need to kind of, here, sit down. Let's talk here. Let's talk. How you doing? It's been a while, right? It's been a while since you've been here. And how's everything? How's everything? Great. I just wonder when are you gonna get around to, you know, get around to that. How we doing? By the way, how we doing, God? How we doing here? Can you give us a little update? You know, how we doing? We're getting close. Not so close. You know, need to tweak a few things. We just, you know, it's just not quite right yet. Maybe sit down. Ask you some questions in the nice chair and here and have a little visit. You can let us know. You know, it's the time, you know, to let us know, well, what are we doing wrong? We can take it at this point. I think we're pretty advanced. We've advanced a lot. And so, yeah, just, you can tell us what was it we're doing wrong. And, you know, how can we fix it? And you know, if you need to tell someone else, that's fine. We'll get someone else in there. It's okay. And hope you aren't mad at us. You know, hope you aren't mad at us. But, you know, we're doing our best. Just help us out. Tell us, how to do. We could do better. God, I think I see how to do it. Yeah. But I ain't gonna do it. Even though I see how to do it, I ain't gonna do it. I don't know, I'm just not feeling, not having a good day, actually, God. That's why. But I see how to do it, I see it very clearly. Yeah, I know how to do it now. Just don't feel like it, that's all. Yeah, just having a bad hair day or something, just been one of those days. I just don't feel like doing it. Somebody said, friend of my friend, of the boyfriend, of whose girlfriend had a friend, who's the friend of another friend, and they told me that, you know, you told them how to do it, and anyway, you know, it's just, I think I can't quite remember what it was exactly. I think, you know, I had a dream, God, that you told me how to do it and I forgot. Silly me. Wow. Can you believe that? Yeah, I had this dream. The angels came, explained it all, clear as a bell, and I woke up and I thought I had it. I tried to write it down and I forgot. I forgot a little bit. Because that's why I haven't been able to give you this gift, you know, of nothing, this non-existent product that just forgot, slipped my mind. I'm not authorized to give it to you, actually. I haven't received the authorization yet. I'm not sure who has the authorization, although I think I heard, at least, that there's somebody somewhere, can't remember their name, who can authorize me. I'm trying to locate them, but I sort of having a hard time doing it, you know. It's tough. I don't know why. It's just all shouldn't be so hard. You know, it shouldn't be so difficult, right? I mean, come on. Shouldn't be. Let's cut to the chase here. You know, there's enough of this talk. Come on. Let's cut to the chase. What's the deal here? What do you want? Come on. You want this, and what else do you want? Come on. Just tell us, what is it that you want? Let's get this done. We're ready to get it done. Yeah. And God says, you know, yeah, I can't buy a non-existent product from you. You know, because you know this is true. There's no such product as forced change, is there? Or no product of forced no change. There's nothing to buy. All this talk is just nothing I can do along those lines. I can't. Nothing I can do at all. I tell you, you need to accept super nature. And from that, set down all your marketing schemes. You know, don't need them. It won't work. Never work. Well, maybe in another cycle, God. What do you think? If you like, end the cycle there'll be another cycle. Is that possible? Maybe in evolution is in shrink the universe and end the universe, and maybe in the next universe, maybe that's possible. Thinking outside the box. I gotta think outside the box here. Gotta think big. Got a really big deal here. Gotta make a bigger deal. This is really big. Gotta make it bigger. It's gotta be huge. It's a huge deal, God. Gigantic. It's enormous. It's awesome. It's everywhere. It's just like the. It's just wow. Let's make this deal. Whoa. Maybe it's too much for you, God. I'll tell you what. Let's try. Let's see if we can help you out with this. There's a little bit of therapy, a little bit of yoga, a little meditation. Maybe that'll help you out. I understand it's a big deal for you, really big deal. It's just something that you had never done before, accepting a non-existent product here, accepting forced change. You know, that's a big deal for you. So we have someone who can help you actually with this. The goddess will help you with this. Look at her, isn't she wonderful? She knows how to get you to accept that. Believe me. Expert at it. So we're putting you in really good hands, God. And we know you won't fail. You won't fail. For sure. You won't fail us. You'll be able to accept it. Absolutely you will. We got full confidence in you at this point. God is a worker magic on you. Before you know it, you'll be able to take that leap of faith and everything will be fine. Everything will be great. Be able to accept non-existent product of this death of forced change. You'll be able to incorporate that into the new paradigm, God. You'll be able to see how it completes what you are, makes you more than what you are. And you'll recognize this is all for the best. All for the best. So, good luck. Good luck at this. Good luck. So, okay. What time? Okay. Spiritual humor. We're into spiritual humor here. As a matter of fact, God, if you, when you accept this, it's going to make you laugh forever. You're going to be laughing forever. You'll be in the best mood ever. Never had such a mood, actually. It's a truly a transcendent mood. It transcends even reality, the mood you'll have. What a deal we have for you today. So, all this lightens up the whole situation, you see. And at least that, this helps us recognize what we've been doing, you know, and forgive ourselves for doing it by having some humor with it. They say, oh yeah, I have been doing all that, haven't I? And it's just God's water off a duck's back. I mean, there's nothing God can do about it. He's just waiting for us to recognize this. Wow. Maybe if we put in a smoothie, God, it'll go down easier, you know? It's possible. A pineapple death smoothie. Yeah. Throw some death peppers in there along with it. Call it good. We know it's hard to digest, so let's just help you out with that. It's the new superfood, God. This death, this non-existent property of the new. It's trending. Actually, it's trending on Twitter right now. Wow, what a coincidence. It's like this is some kind of, you know, synchronicities happening right now. It's trending on Twitter. The pineapple death smoothie that enables God to drink it on down. Yeah, if that doesn't work, our pharmaceutical companies have pretty much figured out, you know, the right kind of medicine to help God with his, you know, with God's resistance. You know, it helps remove the resistance. Again, just about doing some clinical trials on it right now, as a matter of fact. So, it's great. Everything's great. Very optimistic. Absolutely. It's wonderful what's taking place in this world right now, isn't it? Can't help but be proud of what we've accomplished and what we're about to accomplish. Successful mission. Absolutely. All the birds are gliding into their resting places for the evening. I don't know what happened. This place turned into, overnight, there was no, you know, it just turned into bird heaven suddenly here. It's just absolutely nuts. Never seen anything like it. They're just all day, they're just flying everywhere. And just active as, busy as bees, actually. Busy as bees. Ain't this world cute, God? Ain't this world cute? Just so cute, you could just eat the whole thing, couldn't you? So it's so scrumptious, actually. It's so scrumptious. And here you go, and eat death. Isn't that amazing? Yeah. And so you can come up with all sorts of these ideas. Why not? You see, this is just tip of the iceberg, actually. We have a vast array of marketing devices that we have used and continue to use to try and convince God that God can accept this non-existent product that we call forced change death. And God can't, because God's will is reality. And there is no forced change in reality whatsoever. Reality is all there is. There's no forced change, and there's no forced non-change. There's neither one. Neither one. So no matter how we market it, it don't work. It don't work. It don't work. And you know, eventually it's going to start filtering through our thick skulls that it doesn't work. You know, it's not in the style. It's not in the delivery. It's not in the tempo. It's, you know, it's not in the tune. It's not in the melody. It's just not there at all. Can't sell it. to God is impossible. There's nothing to buy. So, supernature. Give it up, you know. Turn it in, trade it in, trade it in for the Holy Spirit's grace. Where, you know, all these marketing things, we say, maybe God will buy this. No, maybe he'll buy this. No, maybe he'll buy this. No, no, maybe not. No, no, I don't think so. No, no. Hey, maybe we don't need to try and sell God something that God can't buy. If you're just non-existent, maybe we can just set that down. We don't even need to do that. Maybe we don't even need to try to do that, do we? Yeah. My continuity fears gotten, you know, really diminished. We'll have a good chuckle with God about this, won't we? We might as well start laughing now, right? Because soon we'll be having a good laugh with God. Remember that? Remember that when I tried to sell you nothing? And oh my God, that was funny. That was really funny. The birds are just bombing. I don't know what the birds are doing. They're just nuts right now. Okay. Fairy green. Hard to explain why the birds are so busy. Huh. Coming from the air, living in the air, living up there, coming down here, intense, is the most intense bird activity I've ever seen. By far. Okay. Hope you enjoyed the video. This is a little different style, but we're bringing in some humor. It's time to bring in some humor here. We need to start laughing at how ridiculous it's all been. Okay, very great. That's it. Hey guys, it's last chance. This is it. No more chances, guys. I'm telling you, no more chances.